Well, we have cabins that are separated by trees and stuff, so it kind of looks like you're separate from everybody in little private spots, although there's one right there. But you feel kind of private. So this is number 4, which has beds for one queen bed, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, I think 5 single beds. When you come in, there's the entrance way that goes either upstairs or in the bathroom downstairs. This is ADA compliant, so it's roomy and large with lots of bars. And then you come down here into the first bunk bedroom, which has 2 bunk beds. And some hooks and cabinet. This is a utility room, refrigerator, sink. And you go in there, and stove. Go in there. And the microwave. Don't have a dishwasher. And Fran will show you around the master bedroom, which is a queen bed. Has its own outside door. Oh, you think it's a double bed? Okay, yeah, double bed. All right. Yeah, it looks like it's probably just double bed.
That's it. Small rooms. I want to meet
you
outside.
No closet. But
no,
cabinet, and the windows are neat that control the shades. They're located inside the thermopane glass between the 2 layers, so you never have to clean it. And the working mechanism is connected from the screen to the window by way of a plastic connection, and that failed in one of the windows.
And then you can open the windows.
And these are awning windows.
Crank, which is really nice.
So it means the window could be open while it's raining lightly and no rain would come in.
Yeah.
Which is a nice thing about that design window. The undesirable thing is when you open the window all the way, like it is right now, you have to look through the screen and the window to see things. It's not a clear view as it would be with a double hung window or a swing out in the other design, the awning that goes vertical instead of horizontal.
But then the neighbors can't peek in either. So.
Yeah. And then we've got big doors here that go to a porch. These are hefty built sliding doors. This is a screen porch. And dinette area with some chairs, all designed for tall people. Fireplace, it's a gas. Then the TV, which is just satellite TV. And then there's a second porch. And this porch is not screened. And cannot open it, I guess. I don't know the trick right now. But it is not a screened porch. Did you lock that sliding door? Oh, okay. So then the upstairs, they come with the basic utensils and refrigerators, pretty decent size. And this is a loft, so any noise from downstairs travels upstairs and vice versa. You can see when we get up here, we have a view down below, and there's high railings for protection. And now what we have is another single bed, and then like a treadle bed. Looks like it's on a slide, so it can be moved around. Not quite sure where else you would move it to. And we have, looks like a skylight with some UV protection. But there's no way to shut out this light. So you basically can go to sleep here and look at the stars on a clear night. and there's no way to make it dark when it's sunny out. I see this screen is coming out. I give you plenty of pillows. Okay, that's the inside of cabin number 4. No campfire ring. There is a barbecue stand. And a little surprised about no campfire ring. They do give you a picnic table. And this is a golf course. Right now you can see there are geese on the course with their babies that time of year. That's an interesting little thing there. Connected with the coax. I wonder if that's part of the Wi-Fi system. No, I think that's part of the satellite dish. Yeah, so you have a interesting design. This is on posts. Elevated off the ground, which might really be nice for protection from varmints and insects. And what is this? There's the antenna for the TV that is not hooked up. Interesting. I'll have to see about that. There's the antenna for the TV.
Cabin?
It's not hooked up.
Oh. Hmm. This is a drainage from somewhere else.
Where else?
I don't know. To follow the pipe. What?
Well, honey.
We wouldn't put sewage out here.
That is interesting. Well, here's our neighbor, just number 5. And then there's more down there, 6. And then Fran says there's some way at the back which are connected together. 4 cabins connected together. Now the one next to us, which I think is 1 and 2, has a walkway that connects the 2 cabins together. Well, there's 4 where we are at, and this one across the street is 3. I'm imagining most of these are pretty much the same kind of layout. What is this, Fran? We're videoing here.
Cabins with a walkway in between them.
Uh-huh.
Might be nice.
Yeah. This would be probably number 1 and 2.
Yeah.
Appears you can possibly just rent 1 if you want. Or both of them. And as I videotape, this gentleman is taking a picture. Very nice. Okay.
So that's kind of nice.
Yeah. So these 4 cabins, which is number 20, 19, 18, and 17, are close together, but not interconnected. And behind them is the golf course. So they might be a bit noisier because of their location. Uh, So across the street from 10 and 11 that are connected is 13 and 14, I think their numbers are. And they have wetlands within walking distance. I'm assuming that you could actually go along the edge of that with bare feet, tennis shoes, or boots, and take samples out of the water of little bugs and crustaceans. Maybe see some fish. But it's an interesting aspect to their locations. Well, this is the lodge. These are obviously rooms. And the main entrance is there. And then they have a restaurant and a swimming pool in the back, a play area. And from this lodge, a short distance, there is a nature center. And you can just see the building over there. Oh, here's the inside the lodge. Gift shop. There's a restaurant there. This is one of their fireplaces. Rooms upstairs. Outdoor porch. Connect to the restaurant. And here's bike storage and bike rental. Bikes are like $7 a first hour and then something thereafter. The main desk. The second fireplace is around the corner. There. And this is like a convenience food bar. And there's the outside pool. And there's a walking trail goes that way. The bike can go that way too. I think there's a playground. Right there, you can just see a little bit of it on the other side of the pool there for kids. So just off that fireplace area, that lobby is access to many rooms and also here to the pool. And this is the area where the main lobby is at. Okay, coming out of that doorway, from the section that goes to the rooms, we have a lake, pretty lake, and a visitor commenting on the lake. Very pretty, make trails, and these are where the bikes were at. And that's the restaurant over there. And we have a pretty day. Plenty of places to walk, especially with kids that aren't too big. There's a pool over there. I wonder if that, in fact, is connected to the lake. There's the beach, Lake Erie Beach. Did you see the beach? Lake Erie Beach? Lake. Very nice. Yeah, right. And another pool over there. What is that? Well, with the outdoor pool we just passed. Like access to maybe it's a boat access area. A wing of rooms. You can see by the windmill that, yeah, the restaurant is in that area. And that's the main lobby area, so. And we're set up here, it looks like, for outdoor event. Maybe a wedding. What did you say?
That light over there is supposed to be the beach lake for little kids.
Over there, that lake is set up for entertainment for kids.
And then there's beach along Lake Erie as well.
Uh-huh, okay. And obviously we're fishing. Boat ramps. And to get perspective, this is the end of the lodge. One end of apartments or rooms. Very nice trails for kids to walk or run. And a complex and interesting setup. With lots of variety of views.
I don't see the playground yet. Somewhere
it's on the other side of the park, Fran.
Oh.
On the other side of the pavilion of the lodge.
Did you see it?
Yeah.
Oh.
You can just barely see it over the swimming pool.
Oh. Okay.
On the other side of the pool. Again, lodge is over there. So I'm just walking around this short path. And there's an interesting building. I wonder what that is. Way out there. It's got a antenna. I wonder if it's a municipal building of types. Police or fire. Park headquarters? Could that be a park headquarters?
What?
Could that be park headquarters?
I have no
idea. Not labeled?
Nope. There's a sledding hill out there somewhere.
Right there?
There's fishing pond out there somewhere.
Right there. Fishing ponds. There's fishermen. There's beach area all along that side.
That's where you can take,
I assume this connects to the Lake Erie?
No,
it's
an inland lake.
This is an inland lake here?
Yeah.
Okay, Fran says this lake here is not connected to Lake Erie.
Is it the beach?
Yeah. Looks like a beach house right there. Go on top of the hill. I'm sure there's a good view if we get on top of the hill here. So there's the lodge for a point of reference with the inlet bay for boats. And we walked up this path to here. And then we can see there is a beach here with small brick walls and sandy outlets that enter the lake. And I think three different places, there's another one there, so you can go out in deeper water. And the breeze from the lake, from cool water at this time of year, it's cooling off this area. So it's supposed to be 80 degrees, it feels more like 70. And then on this other side, there's this inlet lake. Pretty nice size. I'd say it's maybe 20 acres. And there's a beach on the far side of it. This is the amphitheater. The restrooms here. I think that's a concession stand. The walkway. And the building with the green roof, Fran confirms, is the park office with an access road goes along near. Now back to Lake Erie, more of the beach. This appears to be a dike they built. I'm guessing Lake Erie used to go in here, diked it off, and then saved this land as an inlet, as a dry area. Severe weather conditions, as that dike is threatened. This whole area be flooding. A very nice area of lots of walking spaces. Lots of places on the grass, right? And there's a trail that goes way around there. Little kids, you can. You can run and walk forever. And if you come here before school's out, that would be nice.
It would be kind of cool, though.
Yeah, kids don't mind the cool. They would.
Well, they couldn't go swimming.
Iris would.
Yeah, Iris would.
So I took the last set of pictures from there, and we walked this path here. That's the lake and amphitheater. And I can get a better view. Path there. We're going to take that path along the lake back to the lodge. So coming down the pathway, we entered a walkway. We noticed a sign here. I'm not sure if you can read it, but it says, "This is a boating beach, no swimming here." And that over there, that sign might indicate the swimming area. Fran's gonna go check it out. But walking further down the path, past the sign that says no swimming, and we come to the sign where it says swimming. So this area is for swimming. I'm looking at the other side of this dike, you can see that here is another beach area, which is from the inland lake. Lake Erie beach area had a warning about algae, and I don't know if there's a warning for the inland lake. Fran's walking over there, check it out. So coming down the path, we come across the inland lake beach. There's no warning signs here. Well, I'm hoping and guessing that maybe the algae problem more under control here. Don't have to worry about it. Now Fran's walking to the kiosk, and I know there's some people on that hill there. They don't have a zoom lens, so I can't see what they're doing. I don't know what this particular spot is. Okay, close up of the inlet lake beach. Those guys that were up on top of the hill, I checked them out with the binoculars. They have some super long lenses on their cameras. I was speculating they were taking pictures of birds in this area here. Pretty and pleasant. It's a good place for kite flying.
Yeah.
There he's getting it up. There we go. Okay, good. Let out that string. Get it up there. Oh no, bang! Here comes Daddy, I guess, gonna do something. Something brilliant. See, people are climbing up that hill. I don't know if you can hear it, but someplace off in that distance, I think there's a shooting range. We've heard a lot of, sounds like gun discharges.
Oh, that's the sledding hill.
Ah, that's the sledding hill.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Looks like a good sledding hill.
Yep.
So here's the pool with the splash area. And we're checking to see whether cabin guests have privileges to use this pool area. We have jacuzzis over there. Across from the pool is a play area. Go ask. Go ask. Yeah. Uh-huh. And it's kind of like a rubbery vinyl material. Everything's made out of, even though it looks like hard porcelain, it's not. Yeah, play pool costs a dollar. So here we are at the end of the lodge. That's the parking lot towards the front and the nature center. And this is the small playground area with an outdoor pool on the other side. And a volleyball area, lake. And Fran says this is a boardwalk trail right here, which goes out towards the cabins.
Goes back to that parking lot near our cabin.
Right. Okay. Well, you can see this would be a nice trail, constructed in 1992. And takes us into a wetland. It's handicapped accessible. Here's. Yes. Nice. And Fran found out that our room key gives us access to anything that's restricted, such as all these outside doors and the inside pool.
Maybe we could walk this.
After you eat?
Yeah.
Sure.
So here's where the parking lot is. Our cabin's right here.
And we are right there.
This is the parking lot. And you've got that trailhead.
Mm-hmm.
And we could walk back to, this is C, where we are right here,
mm-hmm.
which is up by the lake, or you could go to the nature center, which is over here.
No, that's not the nature center.
The house? Yeah, nature center.
Well, then you're not pointing to the right place.
Right there.
Okay, that's where we started. I thought we said we were starting here. Okay, that's where our cabin is.
Our cabin is right here.
We're not starting there now.
If we went to the parking lot.
Wow, okay. Because right now we're over here.
No, we're at C over here.
Okay, we're at C. Okay, got it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes sense now. I see.
And there's some kind of a viewing area.
Uh-huh.
Way at the other end.
Yeah, okay. So we are at location C.
Yeah, we're mm-hmm. right here. And the lodge is in this area.
No, that. Parking lot. Lodge is right here.
It is?
Yeah. So from this view of the lodge, orient person, nature center, behind that tree, the golf course clubhouse is there, the complex, I don't know which building it is. That's where you start if you're going to play golf. There's a course. It's pretty flat with a little bit of rolling hills and birds all over the place. And then directly opposite is the tennis courts and basketball courts. Coming around back to the lodge. And over here is where we walked and found the boat. And then the inland lake is out in this direction here. The state park offices are out there someplace. And Lake Erie, of course, is all along that side. And then at that end over there, so where the little playground is. And the outdoor pool is on the other side of the lodge there, and the indoor pool is around there someplace. And that nature walk, that's boarded, boardwalk, that goes into the wetland, the shaded wetland area. It goes all along over there, the other side of these trees over there, and then our cabin is located down a road in that direction. So here's the second purple martin house using gourds. They're not real gourds. They're steel shaped like gourds. And we have a sparrow. It appears to take this one down. You gotta lift it up. And then take it off the stand. That looks like a two-man operation or one strong guy. Beginning of the hiking trail that Fran was telling us about earlier, because we're at this location now. Earlier we were up here. We're going to take a walk through this trail when she's not eating lunch. And see lots of telephoto lenses. Hi. Nature Center is closed. This is Saturday. It's closed at 4. And I'm here at 4:30. It'll be open tomorrow at 11 to 3. A monarch gazebo that fine. This is a monarch way station trying to attract them. Not sure having a monarch station near a purple martin house is ideal, but maybe so. Assuming these are butterfly feeders, possibly butterfly attracting flowers. Oh, God. Somebody's in there. Have you walked the trail?
Yep.
Where did you start at?
Started like all the way over there.
C maybe. By the pool?
Yes.
By the playground? Anyone all the way around? Yeah, okay.
Yeah, because like we've seen a whole bunch of birds and everything.
Very nice trail, isn't it?
And
yes.
We've seen like muskrats and stuff.
Oh, wow.
We've seen a big one.
Uh-huh. In the water,
yeah.
On the edges, yes. Very nice.
Thank you.
see, lots of people with long lenses. What size is your lens?
150 to 600.
Using it to emphasize that
95 millimeter.
We have lots of bird watchers here. So the Nature Center is open, so we took a quick look inside. We've got a little observation area here with feeder that overlooks wetland. Blue jay, there we go. Lots of blackbirds, starling. Blue jays having a little trouble landing there, huh? Somebody said they saw a Baltimore Oriole land orange today. Red Wing likes this flat feeder.
Mostly catfish in the pond, it said.
Hmm. More feeders over there. Another orange. And we have animal. Preserved specimens, very pretty. Wow.
Oh, the red wing blackbirds are fighting over the seas.
And a little animal skin area for kids, puzzles, video displays. A little about the history of the area. Simulated wetland things that you might likely see. Bird nest types. And preserved birds, skulls. Skeletons. Mm-hmm. Arrowheads. Oh, reptile snake. It's an eastern fox snake, huh? Pretty.
Look at this turtle.
Yes, small aquarium.
Spiny softshell turtle.
Ah. More displays. Another view of the wetland. More things for kids to touch. That's called a touch table. Quiz. Another observation deck area. Looks like the bird feeders, some of them are empty. Birds of the boardwalk, a list of all the birds. Oh my goodness gracious, that is quite a list. Let's make a quick guess how many there are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. 40 in a row times four rows. This row looks a little tight, I mean loose. That's 160, maybe. I bet maybe it's 150. What do you think, Mr. Owl? Do you think there's 150 birds on that list? Is that a yes or a no? That's a hoo hoo. Is that a barn owl? No, I think they have ears. I have to review my owl names. Oh, that's pretty. Very nice.
We have owl puppets and all kind of critter puppets. There's falcon, and there's puzzles.
My goodness.
I know.
Maybe we should just stay here.
Yes. You're a big puppet. This looks like a lynx. Got whiskers.
Okie dokie.
Yep.
No, there's another room. Another room. Oh, wow, look at this room. Marsh snakes. Water snake. Another turtle. Green frog, yes. Little snake in there. Eastern garter snake, okay. Ooh, black snake. What is this one called? Eastern garter snake also. And there is a turtle. A box turtle. And what's in there? Oh, there's a frog. Toad. Toad over there. Maybe. American toad. Eastern American toad. Milk snake is supposed to be in here someplace. Maybe hiding. He's under the rock. This one's supposed to be a bullfrog. Boo, 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 boo. Doesn't think much of me. Oh, watch out above your head. That real quick raccoon sleeping. Yeah, I got them all. Yeah. Very nice, huh? What are we looking at, Fran?
You are looking at Bernal lens.
From the Toledo Lighthouse, which was removed and is now stored and displayed here.
Oh, there's a picture right there.
Of the lighthouse? Ah. Yes. Used to be illuminated with a whale oil lamp. Did they convert it ever to a some other source of light?
I'm sure they did. I don't know this one as well. I am very familiar with the marlin.
And do you do safety?
Yes, we do.
Water safety?
Water safety, yes.
Class in here?
We are parks and watercraft.
Ah.
Not parks and rec, so we do a lot of watercraft based.
I see.
Yes.
Bows too?
Yes, we do archery programs as well, fishing programs.
Ah. This is Carrie. Kara. Oh, here is the boardwalk right behind the nature center that goes to our cabin area. Makes a big circle. It's a very easy walk. And a gentleman been in this area today, saw 100 birds. Not just here though, he went to 3 other marshes nearby here. He fly away? There he is. There he is. Muskrat, and it's right there on top of a little stump.
It's
a better view of him right now. It's right there.
Having his supper.
And this is what the area looks like that we're in right now. Here we go. Yeah. There's a little raccoon in there. Yeah.
No, I don't really talk that much. I was straight with Teddy, but that's the only thing.
Oh, yeah, there's a baby.
He's coming out.
I sort of end the street.
See the other one?
Yeah, just barely.
Two raccoons in there. I think one's a baby.
So here's the second wood duck or owl house, and a raccoon has moved into this one also. See if I can get you the camera to.
If you move a little to the right, you might get a better view of the opening without the branches and leaves.
I'm trying to see if I can.
Oh, you can see pretty good there.
Yeah, there's something sticking out. There it is.
There's the raccoon.
Yeah.
They took over that house, too.
There it is.
Yep. Pretty resourceful critters.
Yeah. And here's what this area looks like. It's pretty unique to walk on
water.
A wetland.
We're walking on water.
Right in the middle of this area. And I'm also surprised how well these maple trees are doing. The water's about a foot deep, and over here you can actually see the bottom. And between the reflections. And we have plants that are coming up from the bottom. Obviously water tolerant, I don't know what kind. Up ahead we're supposed to be able to see an owl. The bat house, this one fell over. And the small slit at the bottom. The bats go in. It's the second one we saw. More open area. Oh. Hi. Red wing, there are lots of red wings. Swamp forest, seasonally wet area. Should be able to see wild mint, bellflower, and wild iris. Mm-hmm. A little bit further away from the lake. Comes some more birders. Okay, it's hard to see it. But right there is an owl. Sitting in a crotch of a tree. Right above my finger. Maybe related to that house. Ah.
What happened?
There's Lake Erie. Brick wall, and then huge marsh area here. This is at the end of the boardwalk that we're on. A little outreach.
Sunset tonight.
Yeah.
Man, it's getting chilly.
Yes. Here's a muskrat little nesting spot. Where did he go?
Back in the water.
Oh, just when I...
Oh, here he comes.
He's building a nest. A little sleep area, isn't he? Looks like going to be really cozy tonight. I think he's working on his pillow.
Is it recording?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Muskrat. What do you think? Is it big enough? Nope. Oh, that one you just put in is coming out. Well, that's a wimpy one. You can do better than that.
He's so cute. Oh, he's putting grasses in there too. He's making it soft. Look at it. Making it soft.
Is that him or another one?
There's several of them out here.
because it sounds far away.
Yeah, she got them started. That's an owl? I never knew that. It's a screech owl.
Wow.
I don't hear any screeching.
They don't.
They whinny.
I've heard that before.
Yeah.
Now you know what it is, exactly.
It's the little owl you saw in the tree earlier, whatever day. That's what that
yeah.
was.
Ready?
Ready, okay. There it is. It's a gray morph.
Tell me when to turn it off.
Do you see him also?
Oh, yeah, he's right there. He seems like you could turn it off.
It's like a piece of moss.
You got it?
Okay. We see the his backside.
I'm going to turn it off.
Yep. Yeah, you can turn it off.
Gray morph.
It's cool. Thank
you. I got him on film.
Super cool. Yeah. I'm glad we got him to come right in.
The one that came out was probably the naughty one of the litter.
Mm-hmm. Look how she tore up that box.
She surely, and that, we can surely see why.
Repeat that.
We're on top of the sledding hill. It could also be used to roll down in the summertime.
Fishing lake, and let's see the hill. Oh, it's not too steep. It'd be nice in a sled or a wagon. There's a canoe lake over there designed for simple canoe practice with some islands.
So there's the camper host?
Yeah, the camper host. They stay here for 4 weeks.
And what did he tell you about the yurts?
And the yurts, they only have one. They have prospects of putting in the wooden ones, which are similar to what we've seen at other state parks, which have beds. This yurt has 4 beds.
Must be bunk
two
beds.
Two doubles and two singles. I think they're bunk. They have a microwave and a small... college kind of dorm refrigerator and a little table inside of it. And the other campsites that we passed that had a cover over the picnic table, those campsites are kind of special. They're designed for, how would I put it? I think they provide you with some services that you don't get in a plain campsite. Maybe they, I don't know. what else they give you besides what you see there. But that's the only yurt, and you have to rent it at 6 months ahead of time. It's full, pretty much.
Okay.
And these people are here for 4 weeks, and they're part of the Friends of the Park organization, who've built some things around the park. And they have a meeting today at 4 o'clock. Campers that come often are part of that organization. And they're thinking about building a children's playground. They had a wooden one, they tore it down. The state says get rid of it. It wasn't safe anymore. So they're looking at a children's playground construction project.
Ah, cool.
And other people come here after their time is done. Like I said, there are 4 weeks, and they live nearby. So if you wanted to do that, you could sign up and pack your camper right there. I'm sure you could stay for free. And you don't have to stay in your camper or in the site 24/7. You can leave and come back.
But you got to be here for a month.
For a month. 4 weeks, sign up.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you.
And what else did I tell you? I think, they said that the park is, the lakes are pretty good for swimming even into July. It depends a lot on the weather, whether or not there's going to be algae problems.
Yeah.
It, it depends. And it gets very busy, of course, after school's out.
Right. Okay. Lots to
Halloween
think about.
Is a tremendous time to come. I think 2 weeks before Halloween, or a week before Halloween, the whole park celebrates. They have parades. They have contests between all the campers.
It's too cold to go swimming.
Who decorates their stuff the best.
Okay, too much information. So.